Hello. Welcome,
hey.
Everyone. Next match is going to be Powder against Lothar, and I'm sitting here with Zalay.
Hey. So Powder's bringing the fully standard lineup, Druid, Shaman, Warlock, Warrior, and banning Lothar's Warrior. It's a very solid choice.
Yeah, we see Lothar picking the Druid, Rogue, Shaman, and we see a lot of Rogue this weekend, right?
Yeah, we have. It's just a really good deck if you're banning Shaman. You don't have to deal with those Doomhammers. All of a sudden, the lack of defensive Rogue is not as much of an issue.
Yeah, you don't see a lot of Earth and Farseers lately, right? You see the Darkskulker to counter
right.
a little bit of the zoo.
Right, and we've seen Argent Squire as a one of gaining popularity, which is pretty exciting. It's something different and new.
Yeah, it's pretty good against Warrior, right? Since it got not killed by the War Axe. And you can
right.
also buff it a little bit with the Cold Blood to maybe get a good trade.
Even if you don't have the Cold Blood, it threatens the Cold Blood. So maybe they have to deal with that 1-1 Divine Shield, which can be really annoying. Also, once in a while, it comes off of a Desert Camel. I've seen it happen.
Really? Wow. Did you see any Desert Camel Hunters here?
I have, yeah.
Okay, yeah.
I don't remember who, but I saw it.
Yeah, yeah. You need some Wondrobes, right? The problem with Rogue is that you don't have any early game at all.
Mm-hmm. So if you don't have the backstab or the prep to recover,
exactly.
you're just behind.
Or like the coin as I.
Yeah.
If you're missing the coin, you need some early game, right?
It's just nice to always have that nut draw potential of, you know, spending all of your mana every single turn for the entire game.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, and yeah, it can fill up the mana curve pretty well. And yeah, later on, it's still a one mana card, so maybe you can combo something, play one mana card, get Eviscerate, Azai, something like that.
Yeah, turn three, go Argent Squire, Eviscerate your Animal Companion, or Eviscerate your...
Yeah, exactly.
Whatever.
Councilman. I'm really curious about the Shaman of Lothar, actually.
I mean, most common, I would say, is Aggro Shaman with one Lightning Storm, sometimes two.
Yeah, you need that Lightning Storm now with all the Zeus and maybe the little bit of mid-range Warriors.
Right, you don't need it quite as much when you're banning Shaman instead of Warrior, so that's...
Yeah, that's true. But if you play full aggro Shaman, I feel like you're so in favor against Zoo and even Druid.
Mm-hmm.
When the Druid is so powerful now with all the early game cards, with Power of the Wild, Raven Idols, maybe even innervating the Mario Keeper for two minions.
Okay.
Are they already ready? Lothar is online. So let's hope we can
no
jump
game
into
yet.
The match fast.
Yeah, I'm hoping to see some Hearthstone soon.
Yeah, pretty much. Who do you think is favorite in this matchup?
You know, based on the information we have, I'd say it's really close. I think Powder spends more time practicing Hearthstone than Lothar.
Yeah,
so based on that,
true.
I would
yeah.
give Powder the edge.
But still, Lothar is a teammate of Thais and RDU, right?
Yeah, he has some smart people to work with, for
yeah,
sure.
Exactly.
That's a nice advantage.
Yeah, and we saw RDU and Thais already advancing to the next group stage.
Yep, RDU beat the heck out of me.
Really?
Yeah. He banned my zoo and then beat me 3-0 with his zoo. And then my next two opponents, I won three games each with zoo. All so
right.
zoo won every single game I played in my group.
Yeah, seems good deck, right?
I think it was variance. I don't think the deck's that good. I think it's good, but it's not like it's, oh my god, Zoo.
I got 3-0 by Thars in Valencia with Zoo. It was like my first loss there. I was like, oh my god, 3-0 Zoo things. So annoying.
Oh, going into the game? Or
yeah, maybe. Lothar have to invite me. Doing
All
battle
right.
with a friend.
So we have a Druid Mirror.
Yeah.
Wow. Powder's opening hand looks stellar. Living Roots, Innervate, Wild Growth. I might pitch the Living Roots here, because when I have the Innervate and the Wild Growth, it's I have so much mana, I'm looking for something powerful to do with it. And so even though generally turn one Living Roots is a play that's worthwhile, there's some merit to maybe pitching it, looking for bigger stuff so that you don't run out of things to do with all this Wild Growth and Innervate mana.
Yeah, it's pretty good to start with Innervate Wild Growth, but you still need those minions, so hopefully Powder can draw into that. And Lothar is also a pretty good hand, also having the Wild Growth here.
Mm-hmm.
But he has the minions to follow it up. He has the Bloodmage Thalnos, maybe can combo it with Living Roots, and he has the swipe to clear something off.
Yeah, Thalnos is the most interesting card in this hand to me. What do you think about the Thalnos? What does that tell you about his list? Do you have any insight?
Yeah, I think it's just a standard Jog Druid.
Okay.
And they play Thalnos now to deal with the Zoo decks. They they don't ban Zoo, they ban Shaman, or they ban Warrior, so there's always that Zoo, and you need to counter that with like a Thalnos swipe, or
right.
Etelna's Living Rune is also pretty good.
Yeah, there's a lot of spells that deal damage.
Exactly. Also, Wrath is pretty good to deal 2 damage and get a card out of it.
Yeah.
Or even deal 4 damage to deal with the Tomb Pillager or Azure Drake, something like that.
Right. 2 is for sure a key number against Sue because of all the Dark Peddler, Knife Juggler, Direwolf Alpha.
Exactly, yeah. And with
Flame
all the in. With all the rogues coming up, 4 is also pretty good.
Yeah.
Okay, let's see.
4 is also good against Warrior, which he's not banning, right? You see
Frothing,
Frothing Berserker, Azure Drake, Blackwing Corruptor.
Yeah, exactly, yes. Okay, let's see. Yeah. And this is the problem Powder has now. Yeah, he has all the ramp, but he doesn't have the minions. He has to wait till turn 5 that he can innervate that Aged of War. He's still waiting for that. But Lothar is also a pretty slow hand. He only has the Wild Growth here. Not minions to follow it up.
So you have to trade in the 1-1s because your opponent might potentially be hero powering next turn.
Yeah, but it's also scary to leave those 1-1s up for power of the wild cards like that.
Sure.
The wild card just plays the wild card. He's not playing the Raven Idol. He could have gone for the coin Raven Idol, maybe get an innervate, or maybe even go for a minion to get something to play.
I think it's better to preserve the flexibility. Like, the Raven Idol doesn't need... The longer you wait on the Raven Idol, the better you have an idea of what you want off of it. So coining it out, it's like... The coin could fill a huge hole in your curve by saving it.
Yes, and we see a really good draw by Lothar. Sylvanas is so good against Druid, since they don't have any silences anymore, since the Keeper is gone.
And they just play big minions. There's nothing small, so it's going to steal something good.
Yeah, really important to have in the mirror.
So we probably Raven Idol for a spell and play Thalnos.
Yeah, it's...
I don't think we want to save Thalnos. I think it's fine to just cycle it to look for more.
Exactly, yeah, you don't really need the spell damage against Druid, since they probably play one big minion, like the 5-10 taunt.
Right.
That spell damage doesn't do anything.
Well, it does something if he goes like Violet Teacher, Innervate, Power of the Wild. Then you'd be happy to have Thalnos swipe.
Yeah, exactly. That's true.
But it's kind of a corner case.
Yeah.
I'd rather just spend my mana.
Yeah, you want more cards, since your hand's pretty bad. You only have the Sylvanas, and you don't have anything on turn 5, you don't have anything on turn 7 now, so let's see what Lothar can play.
Maybe you think there's merit to taking a minion here?
Oh wow, he's going
he
for a minion.
He does go for a minion.
Wow.
And, which one?
Joust looks pretty good.
It's hard to win a Joust against a Druid.
Yeah, oh wow, he's going for lore.
I can see it. He has 6, 7, 8 in hand, although he doesn't have a solid turn 5 plan, but...
Yeah, it can also just decide to go on turn 5 with the swipe, maybe remove something Powder is going to play. Ooh, Mire Keeper.
So Mana Crystal gets us to Ancient of War next turn.
And yeah, and then you can go on turn 8 for Innervate Jog.
Or you could just Ancient of War this turn. It's pretty big. So now Coin Sylvanas is going to be just an absolute nightmare to deal with.
And Powder is now praying for no Mulch.
Wow. Is Sylvanas better than Mulch, though?
You get so much value out of the Milt right now.
You get so much value out of the Sylvanas, too. They're both insane.
Yeah. Yeah, you get a 5-5 out of it, right? If you play the... But that's pretty scary, too. If you play Sylvanas here, and Powder still has another Living Roots, or a Raven Idol into Living Roots, you're probably going to steal 1-1, so maybe thinking about that. And if you play Milt at 5-10, it's going to die 100%, and you don't get any value out of that big taunt. It's also an innervated minion, so... You don't lose any card advantage or something like that.
Right. Yeah, mulching is great. Just mulch Thalnos, next turn Sylvanas, then Lore, then Ragnaros, and we could innervate, or we could coin something out a turn sooner if we didn't like the Sylvanas on empty board on 6. We could
But it's a pretty difficult turn anyway, so maybe Lore thinking something different, like also thinking about the Sylvanas here. But I still think mulch is really good.
Coin Sylvanas versus Mulch is a really tough call. I think they're both excellent plays.
Yeah.
Sylvanas doesn't actually get any better than this, is the thing. But Mulch doesn't
either.
No,
exactly.
So,
yeah, and it also fills up the mana curve way better, since you don't waste any mana.
I don't think you're wasting any mana either way.
Like,
you can Mulch Thalnos. Playing the Thalnos is a bit of a waste of a mana.
Yeah.
But it's...
Yeah, it's a little bit... Yeah, it's only a cycle for 2.
Yeah.
And we see the Sylvanas here also for Powder.
So this is Mire Keeper making it 2-2 and trading to try and...
Yeah, exactly. And make the chance less for Lothar to steal something good here. But is Lothar lucky? What is he going to steal here? He's stealing the worst one. That's how Hearthstone works, right?
Lothar shook his head. A little bit frustrated.
Yeah.
That's Hearthstone.
But... Swipe
so
can be really good here
is,
now. Yeah,
yeah,
Swipe, Hero Power is clearing everything. And then he can follow up with the Age of War. Looks really good to...
Well, if you're using the Swipe, we definitely want a Thalnos rather than Hero Power, I think.
Oh, yeah, Telnos. Yeah, that looks even way better. Yeah, since the Telnosarx itself too, right? Yeah.
Yeah.
And also having a minion on board is also pretty good. Even mm-hmm. though it's only one damage, it's always a threat that you have there.
Yeah. Okay. One is more than zero.
that's one thing, that's for sure.
All you need. More is better.
That one damage can be so annoying for Powder. No, let's see the Talons into Swipe, clearing everything out. His next minions are going to be so big, and that Rack is so huge against the Druid.
Mm-hmm.
Since they don't, yeah, they only run like one Milt, right? Only one? Or do they run two?
Well, Yugut's been advocating two, and I'm starting to come around to his way of thinking. It really just fills a hole in the Druid toolkit, right? Yeah. Druids are bad at dealing with one big minion.
Exactly.
And so often when you're playing against Druid, you go for that big Yolo Van Cleef, you go for that whatever random large minion, because Druid... Flamewreath Faceless on turn 3 or 4, right? You keep it off with Mulligan against Druid, and you just make them have the one mulch or else they lose. And when you have two mulches, all of a sudden, instead of just losing those games, you're getting an advantage in those games, a big tempo lead.
Yeah, and if you only play one mulch, the chance you're going to draw it in the first 10 cards is
not
really, really small. Yeah,
1 in 3. You're typically mulliganing it too, right? So
yeah, you're not going to keep it.
Yeah, so maybe lower. And then... there's also the factor that just people expect one. So when you're playing two, you use the first one on something medium sized, then your opponent goes all in on the big threat, and you're like, ah, gotcha.
Yeah, gotcha, got a second one, yeah. And Powder's hand is so awkward. He cannot actually play something on turn 7.
That feels bad.
Yeah.
He could have played Sylvanas, but it just dies so easily without getting value.
Yeah, and if Lothar goes for the Aegis of Lore here to draw one card, that Sylvanas getting even more awkward, since you don't want to play the 5-5 into and 5-5 Lore. You can just trade away and you don't get any value out of it.
Right. I imagine as Lothar, I would be playing a 5-10 here. I mean, it's worse against Sylvanas, but it's better against everything else. And, you know, the Druid Mirror tends to be more about tempo than not. So, like, 5-10 is bigger than 5-5. We don't need a card draw from Ancient of Lore right now. We already have plays to make. Like, we have Ragnaros for next turn.
Yeah, Ragnaros is going to be so huge, especially when Lothar can deal with that Sylvanas.
Mm-hmm.
That Reg is going to be so hard for Powder to deal with.
Reg is good against Druid for kind of the same reason that Sylvanas is good against Druid. It's good against the like individual large minions.
Exactly. If you snipe them, at least.
Yeah. Another advantage to playing a 5-10 this turn is you could potentially heal it up with your Ancient of Lore after value trading into an opponent's minion.
Oh, exactly, yes.
Yeah, good play.
And now Sylvanas is finally getting his value here.
Wow, Fandral's so strong, not with his hand, but it'll find its chance. Maybe Yogg draws a bunch of cards, and then you get to do the whole Fandral, Raven, Idol, Wrath nonsense.
And if you can get that Violet Teacher, Fandral, with the Power of the Wild and stuff, there's no way Druid's going to deal with that. You already saw the Telnos, you already saw one swipe. So it's going to be so hard for Lota to deal with a board like that.
So we're going
to
see the same play, but we saw earlier in the game, just flooding the board with minions so that our Ancient of Lore can trade into Sylvanas and hopefully not give up anything too good to Sylvanas.
No.
So but I think we're going to Mire Keeper, make a 2-2, Power of the Wild, make a 3-2, trade, and then Hero Power Face.
Yeah, and hope. Lothar's hoping now that he's that lucky as Powder was.
Yeah.
Is he going to get the 2-2 or is he going to steal the town? That's the big question here, right? But do you go for Power of the Wild?
Yeah, I do.
Yeah? You don't save that for later on with the combo with Fire Teacher and stuff? You don't really need to play it, right?
Okay.
And he steals the town.
Yeah, I mean, that. I feel like that was the most likely outcome. Sure, it's 33%, they're all equally likely, but having played Hearthstone, it feels like if you lose the first Sylvanas flip, you're going to lose the second one too,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, that's how it works. It's the same with Rack. If you play Rack into Rack, your Rack will probably hit the face, and then his Rack will hit your Rack.
Yeah.
100% sure.
Yeah.
That seems probably going to do. But what's the throw? Wild Growth. Yeah, that's not the card you're looking for here.
He had the option to mulch a 5-5 there. He chose to Hero Power Pass instead.
Just swipe clear the board, hit face for 5, seems fine, and he still has to jog to come back in the game. Or even extend his lead, right? Get some cards, maybe get some secrets.
I want to mention, I think Lothar could have Hero Powered Face before trading with his Ancient of War, if that was his intention. I think he might have missed one face damage.
Oh, exactly, yes. Yeah, since you're never going to Hero Power in the 2-2 or the 3-3, right? Emperor.
Yeah.
Emperor can be pretty good here.
Rag's pretty good here, too.
Yeah, if it hits the minion.
If it hits face, it's fine. If it's a minion, it's great.
Yeah. He has to win some RNG in this game, right?
No.
Okay, there we go.
It would be nice if he did, but he doesn't have to.
Hit the minion? Yeah, hey, there we go.
A little bit of justice.
Good job, Luthor.
So Fandral Nourish is pretty strong. Still have two mana to play with.
Yeah, he gets two extra mana. Do we also get that extra mana card to draw? No, you don't get that with Nourish, right? So three cards, getting two extra mana. Oh, and even Innervate.
Feels bad. We just don't have an answer to this Ragnaros right now. I mean, I guess we're setting up to Yogg-Varag next turn.
Yeah, exactly.
Yogg and Believe.
Yeah, you get a lot of spells, especially with the Wild Growth excess mana giving you two extra spells. Ooh, wow. Do you got
maybe... There was some consideration to not playing the excess mana there. Because if you're thinking about playing Violet Teacher next turn instead of Yogg...
You get an extra... Yeah, you get two extra minions. Yeah. Right? You could go for like double Teacher into excess mana, into Power of the Wild, get a full board with insane minions, and there's no way Lothar's going to deal with that.
Yeah, sometimes there are these cute plays with Wild Growth on 10 mana where you play the Wild Growth to spend the mana, but you save the excess mana for the right moment.
Zero mana card seems OP.
So this turn for Lothar is...
Yeah, are you going to kill it with Milch? Since you cannot really take the risk, Rek is going to hit face, right?
I could take the risk. I really don't want to Mulch a 4-drop against Druid. I mean, I can see what you're saying. It makes sense. But on the other hand... I don't know.
If we see the Hand of Power, Lothar cannot see that, right? But
right.
But that Fenrir is going to be so huge if he doesn't kill it, right?
But we saw the plays that he did make with it last turn, and they weren't spectacular, so he could...
Yeah, true.
Like, he has a mana floating, so we know he doesn't have Raven Idol or Living Roots, I think. If he had Living Roots, he would play it, get the 1-1s to make Ragnar shot worse.
Lothar's too scared for it. Clearing it with Milch anyway.
I think both plays are defensible.
Yeah. And now Power can go full ham, right? Or do we go for Jog here and hope for a full board clear?
Hmm.
I think it's too soon to play Jog.
Okay, so we're going something like Teacher, Duskbore, Innervate, Power of the Wild?
Yeah, something like that. And get 7 minions on the board. And then Ragnaros is not that big of a threat anymore, since it can only like snipe a token.
Yeah. Yeah, that's just the perfect 7 minions, isn't it? No, wait.
Two, three, it is 100%, yeah. Yes. And you can even save the... Oh, no, you don't save the Innervate here. Wait a sec. 2, 3, 4, 5.
It's two teachers spawning
but do
two
you
mini
play
teachers.
But do you play the Innervate? You can also go... Oh, you have to play
you
the
have
Innervate.
To, yeah.
Yeah, otherwise, you don't have
it's all it's just perfectly efficient. I mean, the issue is the Rag gets to take its third shot, and the Ancient of Lore gets a nice trade into this Violet Teacher.
Yeah. And also, the teachers get 6 health, so... Trading the lore into the teacher is pretty awkward.
Yeah, it doesn't work at all. Okay. I mean, there's maybe you can hero power with it. We've already seen one swipe out of Lothar, is that correct? We saw the Thalnos swipe.
Yeah, we saw the Thalnos swipe earlier in the game to remove the 5/5 and the 3/3, right?
So Drake swipe. Oh,
wow. What a top deck here. That's so huge.
That's pretty sick.
You can clear every 2 health minion, and then there are like 5 minions.
Yeah.
So much value out of one top deck.
I might Drake swipe face and send my lore to the face because the face damage makes the rag shot to the face potentially much more relevant.
Exactly.
And generally in Hearthstone, you really want your minions to be going face and to be clearing with your spells. And in this case, the swipe clears just as much stuff when it goes face as when it hits a minion.
But if you hit the Violet Teacher and trade into the other one, the other Violet Teacher has only 1 health left, so you can clear that off with the hero power next turn. But Rek can still hit it, right?
Okay. Yeah,
otherwise,
you
missed like 5 damage, or 4 damage, actually.
Alright, I think this is Yogg's time to shine.
There we go, Jogg's run.
Yo,
what
GG.
Are you gonna do?
Alright, the button's green, so you're safe to click end turn if you like. A lot of people like to wait and see what happens. Personally, for me, when it's green, I like to click it. Alright, that's not a good start.
Wow. 860 okay. Rek. Living Roots is gonna deal damage, or it's gonna spawn some minions here. Plotrike, is it going on a 5-1? No.
Okay, we have an execute target.
Yes. Soulfire.
Good enough.
Oh, that's pretty good. Soulfire, right? But you're discarding your Druid of the Claw. That's... Oh, wow.
We're buffing our opponent's minions a lot with this Yogg.
That was it?
Wow, that's...
Oh, no. That was a really bad Jogg's run.
Yeah, this looks like Lothar is probably going to win this one.
Yeah, he can set up for lethal here, right? He can go for, like, 8 damage to the face.
I think he has lethal on board, yeah.
Yeah. If it hits face, then. I think you just... Clear as much as you can. You can only clear 1 token, right? Yeah, that's the only thing you can clear.
Man, I'm really tempted to go face with that 8-1.
Yeah, you definitely go face. You have like a 1-4 lethal if you go for that play.
Well, I mean, trading into Yogg is also pretty good. It's like a safe play when you're in a winning position.
Yeah, but you can still fill up the board with like Fendril into Power of the Wild, maybe even innervating Emperor. So Emperor, Fendril, innervate, Power of the Wild, something like that, and fill up the entire board.
I kind of like Cenarius making taunts. Okay.
Oh, that was Freezing Trap. Yeah,
that's pretty significant.
Yeah. We didn't even see that.
All right, let's never do everything all over again. I really want a Hero Power 1-1. It makes the Ragshot just so much better.
Yeah, I definitely clear token.
And then I think I'm innervating out Cenarius taunts.
Yeah, you also have to be careful that you don't get Savage Roared by a card. They added
Savage Roar, Power of the Wild, these kinds of things.
Yeah, exactly. You have to be careful for that. It's still a lot of damage. We know it from back in the days. Savage Roar on the full board.
What is that? 8, 16 damage for 3 mana? Not bad.
Oh, wow, and it hits face.
Alright.
So scary now. Power is on such low HP, and that.
Wow, Moonkin so swipe. The swipe was a big draw here with that Jungle Moonkin. Things are getting real. So, how does Jungle Moonkin interact with Cursed? I don't think the Moonkin helps the Cursed. The Cursed in Lothar's hand would be affected by Lothar having a spell damage
exactly.
minion.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, it's his card.
Oh, so it doesn't interact, right? Because Moonkin gives both players spell damage.
Oh, yeah. It gives both players 2 spell damage.
So the Moonkin swipe deals 6 to the face and makes the curse deal 4. So he's at 12. Are we 1-off lethal? If he swiped face, I think he was 1-off lethal.
We have to count that. If he swiped face, that was 4 more damage.
It was 3 more damage, right? 6
three
and 3.
More. 7. Yeah, then it was 3 off that.
Wait, the Cursor Farm only did 2?
Yeah.
Is that a bug?
I don't know.
I really think it's supposed to do 4 because the Moonkin's giving him 2 spell damage.
Yeah.
Maybe it's just completely unaffected by spell damage and they patched it or something?
I don't know. It should work with spell damage, right? It's like a damage card, but it's in your hand, so you're not playing the card.
This feels bad, man. This is some Failfish casting. I don't know the mechanics. I really thought that was going to deal 4. I don't know what's going on now. All right, so Fandral, Wrath for a million.
Can you clear almost everything? You can go for Wrath on the Jog, clear the token with your Hero Power, but you really want to Hero Power the face, right? To set up for lethal.
Yeah, it's
you're never gonna Hero Power
decision.
The token here. You play the Curse, right? And then Hero Power? Or do you go for Power of the Wild? No, I think so. Just play Curse.
No, I don't think you go for Power of the Wild. Your life total is so low, and you're so close to having this game locked up. You want to protect your life total by playing the Cursed. Yeah. I agree with that. I can't tell whether you go face.
Yeah, you go 100% face.
You 100% go face? Okay.
Yeah, so you have like a 2 out of 3 good Rack Shield, right?
Yeah,
and
you're
set up for lethal. You have 1 in 3 lethal, and otherwise, there we go. Yeah, there
we
go.
Hey!
Justice.
Good rag.
Yeah.
That rag shot a lot of fireballs. Yeah,
was doing a lot of work for him there.
Yeah.
So that's going to be 1-0 for Lothar, and...
Well, this being last year of standing, winning the first game tends to be a big deal, but less so in this format, because a lot of the matchups are closer to 50-50 in this world of Yogg-Saron.
Exactly.
So you can't counter-queue as much, so winning the first game is a smaller advantage.
Yeah, but I still feel like in last year of standing, if you win the first matchup, you can counter, and then you win 3-2 in the end. Mm-hmm. That's what I see a lot in Lost Hero Standing.
So Powder gets to pick between Warlock and Warrior against Lothar's Druid.
Definitely Warlock, right? If it's a Zulok, actually.
Well, Zoo against Yogg Druid is kind of a close matchup. I'm not sure that you're a big favorite. In fact, I think depending on how the Druid is built, you could be behind in the matchup. Although, in this case, we saw Ragnaros, which is going to favor the Zoo player, because the Zoo player has all these small minions, you know, Argent Squire, Possessed Villager, that are really bad for Ragnaros to shoot at, and a lot of pressure before in the 8-mana turn.
Yeah, and so, if you have a really explosive start as Zoo, since there's a lack of board removal, you're so far behind in the early stage of the game. If they have, like, the Imgang Boss, Councilman, how are you going to deal with all those minions?
The Councilman, in particular, is a big problem for Druid. You often have to, like, Wrath Living Roots it, 2 cards for 1, and you're not even... You're spending the same amount of mana. You're just behind by a card, and that's, like, one of the better ways to deal with it, right? A lot of times it's worse than that. It's just a 3-mana, I kill you thing. But here, Lothar has a spectacular hand. Like, Innervate Mire Keeper is what you want to be doing. Does Nourish fit this hand? How does the curve work?
You don't want Nourish, right? You want small minions like Living Roots, of course, or maybe even Power of the Wild, or even getting the swipe. Nurus is way too slow against you. If you have to play Nurus on turn 5 or something...
Well, we're not thinking about turn 5. We're thinking about whether it's worth keeping because you have Innervate, so you could play it as early as turn 2 for Mana Crisis.
And that's for
but the curve doesn't fit work out that well. Here, Mire Keeper threatens a value trade while...
Do you go for coin, Innervate, Mire Keeper, and then get a 2-2?
No, I'm going for a Mana Crystal. Because the Mana Crystal, like, it's turn 1. It's a really good time to have a Mana Crystal. You get, like, the later you play a Wild Growth, the less turns you get with that extra Mana Crystal, right?
Yeah, but if you can take over the board really fast against Zoo, they have no real comeback potential. If you go for coin, Innervate, Mire Keeper, you can Roth on turn 2.
Mm-hmm.
And if they go for an Imgang Boss or a Councilman on turn 3, you can just mulch it.
Okay.
And they don't get any value out of that. So if you look at that curve...
It snowballs both ways.
Yeah. But also the 3-3 counters the 1-3 pretty good. And you can still go for the Rev Mulch play on turn 2 and 3 anyway.
Right. And the 2-2 can be a liability here if the Zoo player has Direwolf Alpha. He can trade his Voidwalker into the 2-2.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, or an Abusive Sergeant, something like that.
Well, the Abusive Sergeant's not as much of an issue because then it's just trading... Well, yeah, you're right. You're right.
Yeah, yeah. Okay, let's see.
I like turn 1 Mire Keeper, get a Mana Crystal.
Yeah, Lothar's thinking a lot about this... turn. It's a pretty
as he should.
Turn.
It's important.
Yeah.
If he gets this decision wrong, it messes up the rest of the game.
What is he gonna decide? Yeah, he's going for the ramp. He's thinking about the 3-3 contest the 1-3 anyway.
Mm-hmm.
And Powder doesn't have a way of dealing with the
3-3. Powder's in trouble. Feels bad.
Yeah.
The peddler synergies with the brand, but it's more important to make the correct play for the turn. So
you go Soulfire all the way, all time, right?
Yeah, these other plays are pretty bad. Our 2-2 is going to trade into his 3-2 next turn on board, is what we're thinking.
Corruption can be good later on in the game if you can play Corruption on a 5-10 town, or maybe on a rack or something like that.
Yeah,
I really like Corruption. It's a really strong card.
It's particularly good against just big, slow minions.
Exactly, yes.
Like Druid can often play.
And if they play Aged of War or something like that, they can only trade a 1-1 or a 2-2 with it, and they don't get any value out of it anyway.
Right, so this is a pretty simple turn. We Wrath that Dark Peddler and value trade into the Voidwalker. The Wrath protects our 3-2. It matches about tempo and board control.
And you have to swipe, so that's really important to have, especially when you go full ham with the Forbidden Rituals, cards like that. But most of the time, you just wait with Rituals after the swipe.
Lothar's, he's in a great spot for now, but it's really important what card he draws each turn, because he doesn't really have a good play for next turn necessarily. Nope. Like, a lot of times this swipe is not the greatest play on turn 4. If he swipes that, the Imgang Boss or Brand is what we actually see is likely to come down, then he's much more exposed to something like a Forbidden Ritual. Although, looking at Powder's list, I see Soulfire and Argent Horse Rider. To me, that means there's no Forbidden Ritual, there's no Power Overwhelming.
You see a lot of Argent Horse Rider decks lately in Zoo.
Yeah.
So only one, even though when they play ritual lists.
So what do we... Oh, it's just Horse Rider.
You can just trade now with
Horse Rider's great.
Yeah. But Lothar doesn't have a turn 4 play, so he can just use his hero power and remove... Oh, wow.
Yeah, make some 1-1s.
Yeah.
Clear the board.
Really good. But Powder's perfect.
The best
for
draw
the
there is what? For 4 mana.
Mario Keeper again?
Yeah, sure. I'd probably Wild Growth again, looking at my scenarios.
Yeah, exactly, yeah. You want to go to the scenarios as fast as possible. Scenario is so good against Zoo, since you have 2 minions that can deal with almost every Zoo minion.
Mm-hmm.
And also the 5-8 can get so much value.
Well, I don't entirely agree with you, because saying the 2-2 can deal with almost any Zoo minion, it's like by the time you get to 9 mana, you're typically behind on board. So I think they're value trading into those 2-2s pretty consistently. Just some stupid 2-3 like a Defender of Argus is going to value trade into them. And then, the 5-8 body is big and going to do stuff, but it's also slow. You might die by the time it gets to
crazy times. Just ignore it.
Yeah.
Yeah. Leave it up and just go phase all the time. Let you deal with their board. But that Living Roots was pretty good. You can clear the minions and, oh, wow. Doomguard. So he's playing the Doomguard.
Well, 4 mana, so Brand Voidwalker this turn. Kind of have to do it. I mean, Zoo's behind. Druid had a great opening, and Zoo did not, so...
Ooh, Fendril.
Very strong. Not this turn. We probably want to swipe and clear, right?
Yeah.
Because if
you
don't clear the brand, it's very dangerous.
Can you just mulch it and hero power and just clear everything? I think you want to keep the swipe for later on in the game. Swipe can get so much value against Zoo.
Well, Lothar did see the Argent Horse Rider already, which is sort of an indicator that there's no Forbidden Ritual, which is an argument for using the swipe sooner. But you're right. Let's see. So Mulch can kill a Sea Giant or a Doomguard.
Yeah.
So it could potentially kill something bigger that way.
Yeah, next turn is turn 5, so maybe Lothar's thinking about turn 5, maybe Doomguard coming. And we always see the Doomguard in Powder's hand.
Yeah, it makes a lot of sense, right? If we swipe and trade our 1-1s, a lot of times Zoo is just going to Doomguard on 5 and we get to mulch it. And we feel good about the decision we made.
Yeah, and the longer
it's
you can
stall... It's easy to say this looking at his hand.
Yeah. It's easy for us, yeah. Lothar has to sign it, but...
Yeah.
Yeah, I think Lothar just wants to survive till the late game. When all his good cards came out. And he's doing pretty well.
He's... doing great. He had turn 1 Mire Keeper that got the value trade. Like, that's and he makes the play that I like. Good job.
You normally don't see value trades like that with Druid against Zoo. They always have an abusive Direwolf and Power Overwhelm. They always have something to buff their minions. Yeah. But do you go Doomguard here, or do you just go for
Imgangbol
Step? Yeah. Oh wow, and he keeps the Imgangbol. That's pretty big, I guess.
I might have preferred to keep the Soulfire because my hand's so small. I'm not sure.
Yeah.
And Imkang Boss often doesn't do a good... Like, Imkang Boss is at its best against small minions, so it can trade in and survive to keep making more 1-1s, and Druid tends to be more on the large minion end of the scale. So here I think we just have to mulch and Hero Power
Just
face.
Mulch Hero Power, and then the Druid's power is coming out.
It feels bad. We're kind of... we were trying to gain tempo by mulching a Doomguard, but as it turns out, we're wasting the rest of our 3 mana, so it's not really a tempo
game.
Like,
no, it's a...
Stable Master. This is just a vanilla 3-mana 4-2, right? I can't think of any way he's going to get beasts. Can you discover a beast? Stone Tusk Boar off of Peddler?
Yeah, that's the only thing, yes.
Oh, there's a beast!
Oh, wow, yeah, Direwolf, Direwolf, wow, yes.
Okay.
What? But that's so good of Zoo. They can just keep tapping. If they remove their entire hand with a Doomguard or Soulfire, tapping in all those small means, and Lothar's getting behind on cards if he...
This is a good turn for a 5-10. You can tell because he has 7 mana.
7 mana, 5-10 time. Yeah. And Powder need a Power Overwhelm or something like that to deal with it.
Yeah, but I don't think he plays any. I think he has Soulfires and...
He can get Peddler. You always get Soulfire or PO out of it.
there's
Soulfire.
And he can play his whole hand. So he's probably going to do that.
Oh, it's so awkward for Powder. He has to trade both his minions in and play the Soulfire.
Yeah, but I mean, at least he gets to kill the thing.
Exactly. And you still have a pretty decent
three minions
board. You have
on
like
board.
The Direwolf, the Stablemaster, and the token from the...
Imgang boss, yep.
There we go. Such a good top deck there.
Synergy, it's immune. I don't know what this card does. Yeah, immune this turn. Yeah, it does nothing.
It looks cool. It looks cool for one turn, right?
Nice little bubble there.
Wildgrove. Yeah, that's doing nothing.
Ooh, unfortunate. There were a lot of draws that are really good here. Something like Wrath to go with his Ashtray or Fandral.
So Fandral into Wrath on the Stablemaster. And then Hero Power on the 1-1. But I think you just play Drake. Get a card.
Drake and try and draw something like Living Roots or Wrath.
Yeah.
Just anything we could play, really.
Yeah, Living Roots would be the best. So you get Living Roots and Hero Power.
Yeah, okay. That would be excellent.
But Wrath is fine, too.
Get the draw card. It's not so bad.
Yeah, Fandral is actually doing nothing here. You just give it away to the Stablemaster. Whoa.
Even though Zoo's ahead on board, it looks like he's not ahead enough on board to make up for how many cards that Lothar has.
Is Lothar really thinking about playing the Fandral here? I think the Fandral is completely useless here. Since you just give it
away to... It's a weird play.
Yeah. What is he thinking about?
He's going to play the Drake. He's just thinking about his outs or whatever first. I don't know.
But do you just play Drake? You want to draw your out first and then think about it. There's no other play.
I mean, Lothar spends time with Life Coach, right?
Yeah, maybe.
I think that's what's... like. I don't think he was ever not playing the Drake.
Yeah.
I think he just wanted to think about stuff.
The power of a wild is actually really good. Since he has the Fandral already in hand. Yeah, you go for scenarios next turn. But if after that, you can go for Fandral, Power of the Wild, buffing everything.
Yeah, we keep having these solid turns where we get to wait and potentially draw into even better Fandral turns.
Oh, yeah, he's playing that 6-0 version of Zoo.
Yeah.
With the ref cards and stuff.
Yeah.
Really aggressive version of it. Yeah. Do you play the... Get in there and fight, maggots! Do you like trading the Direwolf away? I think the value from the Direwolf is way more than a 4-2 vanilla, right? I don't know.
I think it's debatable.
Yeah.
That's a tough one. I'd really have to sit there and hem and haw over that one for a bit.
But scenarios looks really good for Lothar here. Deals with two minions. Even though the Wrath card can value trade, You can just clear it so easy with the hero power. Oh, wow, we saw the Violet Teacher, actually.
I don't think Zixo played Possessed Villager or Knife Juggler.
No, no, he didn't. But look at the hand of Lothar. Next turn is going to be insane. You can go for Violet Teacher, Fandral into Power of the Wild. That's going to be sick.
Yep. The Druid big mana turns can be... Oh, wow.
You don't go for that, right?
It's not as good.
Nah, I think you just go full ham here.
Fandral Teacher, Power of the Wild.
Yeah. But you have to be careful with your life total. There's 11 damage on the board, and you're on 14 health. You can only clear one minion.
There's going to be 7 after we clear. So we're going to die to 7 damage, which is something like Doomguard Abusive.
And also, the Knife Jigger is still on the board. Okay. So that can also sneak in some damage. But if you play Defendrill, Fire Teacher, there are a lot of minions.
A lot of things that the juggle don't go face very often.
Exactly.
There's a few ways. We could also do something like Teacher, Wild Growth, Power of the Wild, Hero, Power of the Wrathguard, and trade into the Stable Master.
Yeah, exactly. And then leave only three damage on the board, and you only gain 1 extra health since you hero power.
Mm-hmm. And the Wild Growth could draw into something good like a Wrath, save some life.
So you play Wild Growth first, I guess?
Well, I don't
see what you draw.
It looks like he's not going for that play if he's trading first. Okay.
Okay. Always draw last.
Get that tilt value out of your opponent.
Yeah.
Probably doesn't matter.
No. Top deck swipe. Oh, ooh,
Living Roots is pretty good.
Yeah.
You want a Living Roots before you Power of the Wild.
Oh, wow. Was he too late?
Yeah, it looks
he's
like
not, he's knocking his hat.
You know, he's been him and Life Coach, right? It happens. I've roped before.
Yeah.
All right, so.
But he still has the Living Roots for next turn, though.
3, 5. We need 6.
If we
juggle
it?
Face twice and hit a 4 damage card, is that lethal?
Ooh, Battler into PO. Oh, Stone Tisk Wars, 1 damage? You go for, I think you just go finish here, right? It's the most sticky minion. You can also decide to go Gold Shard or Footman.
I guess you're thinking is we want to... We don't have Power of the Wilds in this deck, so having a sticky minion might not be as important as just pushing that 1 damage.
Yeah.
I'm trying to think. We've seen 1 Doomguard and 1 Soulfire from the deck, or has it been both Soulfires already?
No,
I think Doomguard pitched a Soulfire, and we played a Soulfire later.
Yeah, the Soulfire was from the first battle, I guess.
Okay.
Yeah, we took the Soulfire over the Corruption. Earlier on in the game. Oh, this is still looking pretty good for the zoo. Since Lothar can make a really big board, but he cannot deal with the minions, and he doesn't have a taunt yet.
Nixie is a bit slow here. I think this turn is something like Fandral, Living Roots,
yeah, but then
the
you're
Juggler.
Dead, right? Then you're dead to a lot of things. Do you just go for Nourish? Maybe draw into Swipe or something? I don't get
it. Yeah, I mean, it only costs 3 mana. You can't draw into Swipe unless you have Innervate as well.
Yeah, but if you just play Nourish and don't play the Fandral.
I didn't like Nourish. I liked Fandral. Okay. So here we have Living Roots and Wrath.
And
so we Living Roots the Juggler. We Wrath a 2/2. We trade into a 1/2, and he has 3 power on board. He needs 6 to kill us.
Yeah, exactly. And it's going to be really difficult.
So no
since
one
Doomguard
card.
Is only 5.
Two, yeah.
And he already played 2 Petlers. He already played 1 Soulfire.
And with this level of board dominance, I mean, we're even setting up lethal. So this is going to be Powder's last chance. Find the 6 damage or die trying.
Yeah, really good pickup there for Lothar too. If Powder can survive, the Swipe is probably going to finish him off.
That's it.
That's not doing it. Can he pick up 6 damage here?
No.
No, that's a Doomguard and now he's 1 off.
Yep.
Wow. That's how Hearthstone works.
Yeah, just the tiniest little advantage. 1 damage short at the end of this. That's savage. And this happens a lot. I mean.
But can he survive, actually, if he trades with the Doomguard? He can trade the Fandral away. And he can also clear the Teacher, right? So it's still not over. But the double power of the Wild is probably going to do it for
Lothar. I'm looking at Lothar's hand, and I'm thinking this is over.
Yeah. Double power of the Wild into Swipe phase, probably lethal.
Yeah.
Yeah, there's still 5. 4 minions on the board. It's going to be 8.
Yeah, plus
12 swipes.
Powder just has to take an aggressive line to try to win the game. You know, he can't see Lothar's hand. He has to hope it's somehow nonsense that he can... You know, if you put him down to 4, maybe you can top deck Soulfire and kill him. That's what he's thinking. Put him down to 3 so when he hero powers, you can still Soulfire kill him.
And that's lethal for Lothar. And that's 2-0 for Lothar. It's going really well for him. And Druid is doing a lot of work for him now.
Yeah, I mean, Druid has those Innervate and Wild Growth starts that are just really powerful. You can win any matchup, right?
Yes. Also that fire lit teacher giving all those 1-1s training. Trading really good with all the small minions of the zoo. Yeah, well done by Lothar. Powder is only the warrior left.
Warrior typically has good sweep potential. I mean, warrior's probably the strongest class right now. So usually zoo's what I would say 3-0s the most often, but warrior has reasonable chances. I'm not sure what Powder's warrior is. I think this is his first match played in this tournament, so yeah, we don't really have any solid information on what he's playing.
It's probably going to be a version of Dragon Warrior. I think that's one of the most popular warriors nowadays, especially in tournament formats.
Yeah.
Maybe Katoom Warrior is still pretty good.
I mean,
we're going to see
it. So Dragon Warrior.
Yeah, we already see the Dragon in the starting hand of Power.
So do you keep the Azure Drake since you have that Alexstrasza champion?
Yeah, you can even keep the Execute too. You can maybe go for an all keep. I think Execute's pretty good against Druid.
Execute's definitely good against Druid. I still want to mulligan it just because I'm trying to not play it in the early turns. I want to save it until they get to their 7 mana, 5-10 turn.
Exactly.
And so I kind of want to pitch it in the early game and try and find other ways to deal with their Druid of the Claw and whatever.
Yeah, but you already have the insane start with the War Axe, with the Alexstrasza champion. You have the Dragon. What do you want to mulligan for? If you throw away the Execute, what do you want?
I love Frothing Berserker or Twilight Guardian. I want those turns 3 and 4.
Exactly,
but,
yes.
Like, I'm not going to say keeping Execute is wrong, because all of what you said is true.
Yeah. Let's see what Powder is going to decide here. And we see Lothar again having the Innervate, or at least having some kind of ramp.
I mean, as Dragon Warrior, you're always keeping that War Axe, you're always keeping that Alexstrasza champion. The question is, can you keep the Azure Drake and the Execute because of the context of the rest of your hand?
Yeah.
I think the answer is yes, you can. You don't necessarily have to.
Yeah.
He agrees with you. He likes keeping the Execute. Okay.
It's so good Execute. If they're innervating on turn 5 in Age of War and you don't have that Execute, you're going to lose the game so hard, since you have to trade your Twilight Guardian or your Azure Drake into it.
So he chooses not to coin champion and start pushing 3 face damage. It would play into Wrath on curve. He would have a follow-up of turn 2 Fiery War Axe, but no turn 3 follow-up. This way he has a guaranteed 2-3-4 curves kind of thing. And if he's Wrathing the Alexstrasza champion, it's going to be off curve.
Definitely. And you want to coin out maybe a 4 or 5 drop.
Right. I like this pickup of Mire Keeper from Lothar last turn. He can now Innervate Mire Keeper for a Mana Crystal, curves right into Violet Teacher on turn 3.
Yeah, Violet Teacher is so good. And now the Execute can be really handy to kill that Violet Teacher.
Yeah, but I think executing a Violet Teacher is something I'd really rather avoid. I want to have that Execute for later in the game.
Yeah, definitely. Yep.
Mire Keeper will get killed by a Fiery War Axe, so that's a very clean answer for Powder. Turn 2, Fiery War Axe, kill 3-3 seems good.
Yeah, War Axe is such a good card.
Wow. Oh. So,
War Axe into Frothing Berserker, into Corkrawl, into Drake seems really
nice.
Really good curve for Powder here.
If you had coined that Alexstrasza's champion on turn 1, it would have worked out better, but that doesn't mean it was the correct play, right? He didn't have the information about Lothar's hand. So.
Oh, exactly. And dealing 3 face damage doesn't mean anything against Druid, right? You probably win on board control. If you can spam your entire board with strong minions, there's no way the Druid can deal with that, and only dealing 3 damage playing into Wrath is not worth it.
Right.
Wow.
This Violet Teacher is getting better. If we just Emperor, we could make a safe play and just swipe that. How do you get punished if you play Emperor here? Slam second Fiery War Axe would be a disaster.
Yep. Maybe Rev Chinku into Execute? It's a pretty big punish.
I don't even know if I'd call that a punish. Like, anytime he's using his Execute on just the 5-4, it's like, it's good, but the follow-up turn from Druid of, you know, Violet Teacher, Wraith and Idol swipe is fine.
Yeah, but if you can just swipe Raven Idol into a spell, it's pretty good, right?
I like to save the Raven Idol for when I have Violet Teacher in play. I like Emperor this turn.
Yeah, you can also just swipe Hero Power.
You could also swipe Hero Power, but I like Emperor. I like going for it.
Yeah, Emperor is such a big threat. Powder has to deal with that. They cannot leave it up. They have to make some kind of suboptimal play to remove it.
Mm-hmm. Okay, he goes for the safe play.
Yeah, I really agree on playing the Emperor there, since they have to remove that Emperor. You cannot leave it up. There's no way.
Right. I mean, it's a risky play. You took a safe play. That's fine.
That Hand of Powder is so good. He has, like, everything you want as a... Do you go for double Alexstrasza's champion?
Yeah, it's like it
Six
uses
damage.
Up the most flexible card in your hand, but it puts the Druid in a spot where it's harder to deal with your board, right? If you Corkron Elite, all it takes is one Wrath to deal with the board.
Exactly, yeah.
This way...
Even Living Roots Hero Power deals with it. Or, like, Ezra Drake into Living Roots with you. That's so easy. And now it's pretty awkward for Lotar.
Teach your Living Roots Hero Power, clears one of the 3/3s and makes a pretty threatening board. So that's an option.
Yeah, it's a 3/5 and a 1/1. Is that threatening?
Yeah, the 3/5's threatening.
Yeah, you have to remove, but you have so many ways to deal with all those 1/1s. Those Rev Chingul. Yeah, it doesn't have the Rev Chingul though, but Lotar is thinking about that.
Right.
You can also go for Raven Idol into Emperor, filling up the mana curve.
Yeah, again, I think I want to hang on to the Raven Idol.
Yeah, but your hand is pretty bad, and I think you're looking for some other cards.
Okay. Yeah, I mean, Raven Idol Emperor is reasonable.
And if you play Fire Teacher, yeah, you can go for Fire Teacher. Since Sparta has to remove that Fire Teacher, maybe has to make that suboptimal play again.
I like this Teacher, Living Roots play.
There we go. And it's always good to remove minions from the Dragon Warrior. If you can keep removing all their threats, you will probably win in the late game, since they run out of threats. So.
Sure.
And they don't have a lot of... They don't play brawls and stuff, so if you can remove everything and develop your own threats, it's really hard for the Dragon Warrior to come back.
Yeah, Dragon Warrior does kind of run out of cards at some point. They don't have the Nourish to reload their hand.
Exactly, yes.
The Druid is the control deck in the matchup, right?
Yeah, and they have the Jogs run to make that insane comeback if they are behind.
So here we're definitely scared of that Violet Teacher because we don't have a Ravaging Ghoul, so we don't feel good about leaving it up and letting it go wild with 1/1s. But we also don't have a very clean way to kill it. Like, trading in our Alexstrasza's Champion and using Execute feels awful.
Yeah, that feels awful.
But it might be the best we have.
Yeah, you can also decide to Corcron and trade both in, but that's also really bad. If you use the Execute now, you should be fine. And you didn't see a 5/7 taunt on turn 7, so you don't have to be afraid of that. If Lotar had that Age of War, he would have played it 100%, right, last turn.
That's a good way of looking at it, so it's not as bad to use the Execute.
Exactly.
It's never 100%, though. Like, I don't know if I would say it's 100% he would have gone for Ancient of War over that, because the thing about playing Ancient of War is you're aware that no Execute's been used. So maybe you're thinking, oh, I'll play Violet Teacher first, this is okay, see if we bait
and bait Execute. Yeah. You can think about two ways, yeah. Yeah, it's just straightforward Emperor turn.
But Emperor, still... Hero Power, no attacks?
I still think you play Raven. But do you go a minion or a spell? I think you have to go for a minion here.
Really?
Yeah, but what are you looking for in a spell? You don't want to get behind on board, so you need minions.
Well, I think spells are fine as removal against the Dragon Warrior minions. Cards like Corcron Elite and Frothing Berserker are important to remove, and they have fairly low health relative to how high their attack value is.
Lotar goes for a minion, though.
Okay, so he agrees with you. can we see the minions anywhere?
Yeah, can we? Oh, wow, he gets another one. Well, second time.
Costs 7 mana.
Yeah, but he can actually go for the card draw here, since he has no cards.
I would definitely go for card draw here. Yeah. It's just a question of whether you'd rather play Emperor or Lore.
Yeah, definitely Lore.
I agree.
It's a 5/5, and Emperor...
They're the same size body, it's just like this way you have a bigger hand to Emperor next turn.
Really? Like
trading
the
1/1 plays around something like a Ravaging Ghoul.
Ravaging Ghoul.
Does it play around a Ravaging Ghoul? Because the Ravaging Ghoul would put damage on your Twilight Drake anyways, so then your Lore is still trading into it cleanly.
Yeah, but maybe Corcron can trade into the... So like a charge can trade into the 1/1, get a value trade on the Age of Lore, but they don't play cards like Blood to Ichor and stuff.
Yeah, I mean, maybe the 1 damage on the Twilight Drake is relevant so that we could potentially swipe Hero Power next turn, is what we're thinking.
Yeah.
Although really, I'd like to be Emperoring.
And we see the swipe in the hand of Lotar, so... Okay. Wow, Nexia.
Yeah, it doesn't seem very safe with that Frothing and Corcron sticking around if we play a Nexia.
But can you deal with this?
I think we have to swipe the Frothing, innervate Emperor. And we trade into the Twilight Drake. We take 4 down to 12.
Yeah, that seems the correct play. You can also decide to swipe... Yeah, you have to clear the Frothing. It's
yeah.
Got out of hand really, really fast.
So it looks like we actually got punished for trading our 1/1 in last turn.
Yeah.
It just didn't do anything.
No, and if you did have the 1/1 left...
It wouldn't change too much, but you'd have a 1/1. Like, you know, it goes face for 1 and it's there.
Yeah, true, yeah. Just swipe Emperor here. Develop a main is also good.
Yep.
You can trade in the later stage of the game with the main. Yeah, He has two really big minions on the board now. And that Korkong can trade into the Age of War, but then there's still that that Emperor. And 8 mana Onyxia can be actually really good if you can get a Wrath into the Onyxia. So,
yeah.
So you can play an 8 mana Onyxia with Wrath or maybe even Hero Power to clear something.
And just Hero Powering is very irrelevant at this point in the game with how low your life total is.
Oh, wow. And this is a really tough turn for Powder. He has that Dragonite Crusher.
Yeah, 6 mana is a good price to pay for a 9-9.
He's going.
If there's no Mulch, it's like...
Yeah, that's exactly what we were saying, right?
So how do we deal with this?
Just Wrath, just trade both in, play an Onyxia.
Onyxia on an empty board seems good.
Yeah,
I was overthinking it.
I already saw...
Clear the board, play Onyxia, okay. Yeah.
I already saw a lot of threats from Powder. You already saw the Frothing, the Taunt, one Dragonite Crusher.
It feels bad to trade your Emperor in until you realize the Emperor discount's literally doing nothing for you here. It's just a 5-5.
Yeah, 5-5 seems pretty bad.
Yeah, this is
like
one of those turns.
Like a buff J.A.T. Just the Wrath. You can also decide to Wrath for one Hero Power, but then you take too much damage. Just remove it.
If you Wrath for one Hero Power, you're not playing Onyxia.
Yeah, no.
That doesn't
seem
good.
Draw into something nice, but... Yeah, Onyxia is just too good
This is just too good. It's too clean.
And all those 1-1s can deal with the Drake and the Corcoran rather easy, right?
Powder gave Lothar a bit of a look, like, that took you your whole turn?
Yeah. Yeah, pretty difficult turn, of course. No activator for the Grommash yet, but Powder can decide to just hammer the face.
Yeah.
Or go for Azure Drake to get that activator, like a slam or... they don't play Bloodstriker, so only Slam can activate the Grom here.
He doesn't play Bloodstriker.
Do you play Bloodstriker in
Dragon
Warrior?
Yeah.
It's a really good card, but you already have so many early game, right?
Alright, that's theoretically an activator.
Yeah, can
the
be
armor
a bin?
Up doesn't change anything. You're dying into two turns to that Druid board either way.
Yeah. And you can also get the Hunter Hero Power to set up for a two-turn lethal.
Yeah, the thing is you have to kill him next turn. So how do we do that?
Oh, yeah. Maybe tap, get something good.
I mean, Fire Blast seems like it has to be the pick. If we can somehow just survive to the turn 10 Grommash ping, maybe we can win that way. It's really rough.
We can get another...
We just draw the second execute for Onyxia.
What a draw by Lothar. Yeah, he must be really happy about this card.
Yeah, I mean, he probably had several draws for lethal there. Anything like Power of the Wild.
Wreck.
Yeah, the Rag would have been good. The War would have been good.
That's pretty good, too. But the question is, how are you going to play this? Yeah, you're probably going to trade 4 tokens
into
the Drake.
You got to be safe, and then the other 9 go face. There's no way you're trading 8 into a Finley.
No, and there's the difference between 12 or 11 damage doesn't matter at all.
Yeah.
Since you don't die to Grommash anyway.
Yeah, so it's just Drake, clear the Ash Drake with 4 1-1s, 9 to the face.
So Powder was 1 damage of lethal last turn, now he's 1 mana off lethal.
Yeah. One thing to momentarily consider is 9 to the face, we're putting the Warrior at 12, which is like Mortal Strike and Revenge, but they're not playing those cards in Dragon Warrior, we don't care.
You're not going to think about those cards in the Dragon Warrior deck.
Yeah. But in general, you know, you're playing against the Warrior, you just pay attention to when you're putting them to 12. Sometimes you skip a damage.
Alright, picks up Power of the Wild.
That would have been lethal. I think. I don't know.
Yeah, if he had it one turn earlier, yeah. What is he gonna pick up? Oh, Dragonite Crusher. Yeah, that's not doing it.
This is pretty tough.
Yeah.
So
is he gonna survive? Yeah, he can actually. He can just trade a Finley in the 1-1.
Yeah, so as Powder here, your goal is to set up lethal while being as defensive as possible, right?
Grommash. Yeah, now he's set up for lethal next turn.
It's not really set up for lethal, because on board, the Onyxia is going to...
It's no lethal.
...trade into that Grommash.
Are you, actually?
So, so if we play Rag and go face, we probably lose a third of the time and probably win two-thirds of the time.
Yeah, exactly.
But what happens if we play Ancient of War and trade into his Grommash?
Then
don't we just probably win 100% of the time?
Yeah, probably, yes. And you can even play the Power of the Wild for a 3-2 minion, maybe to trade into something later on.
Or you could save it to combo with Fandral if you're really greedy, but do you want to be greedy here?
He's already on 12 HP. I don't think you need combos like that anymore.
Yeah.
You just want to play as much as possible right now. And
The Power of the Wild 3-2 is really relevant for trading into Finley, so our Rag shot's better the following turn.
Exactly, and you can also trade in in cards like Corcrom or they already played 2 Alexos champions, right?
Yeah. No, it's turn 4.
That doesn't be relevant anymore. Okay.
See, I just taunt up, trade into the Grommash. It feels bad for Powder that he had to play his Grommash there because it was kind of his win condition, but you gotta do what you gotta do sometimes. Okay, he chooses to save the Power of the Wild.
I really like playing Power of the Wild here.
He figures he can rag and hero power that 1-1 next turn.
Yeah, that's actually the same.
It's not really the same, though, because it commits to using the mana.
Slam into execute?
Yeah. Are we doing it? No.
No, Drake into execute? Drake into execute is still
a
thing,
he just
right?
wants a 9-9. 9-9s are big. I can see the appeal.
Yeah. And now rag is actually not that great anymore since...
Yeah, potentially hitting a 9-9, it's a disaster.
Yeah, it's doing nothing.
Now, if he had the 3-2 in play...
He could make...
He'd still kind of have to deal... He still wouldn't be dealing with Finley. Right? Like, if the 3-2
yeah,
goes
true.
Into the 9-9, then he's not dealing with Finley. But it would be...
Now, you could trade the Aged of War into the Finley.
Mm-hmm.
Trade the 3-2 into the Dragonite Crusher. And get a 50-50... A face or on the Dragonite Crusher.
Okay, this ping was actually quite interesting. He pings it down to a 5-7.
Yeah, why?
It's not relevant for Dragonite Crusher. Maybe he's thinking it's relevant for, like, Corcoran plus stuff.
Yeah,
somehow.
But what, you don't have Alexos champion anymore? You cannot really face tank with a War Axe, right? And if you play War Axe Corcoran next turn, you can still ping it.
Yeah.
If you had the Power of the Wild, you could trade the Finley with the 5-7, trade the 3-2 into the Dragonite Crusher, play Rag, and have... A 100% good shot, like face or on the Dragonite.
So here's Lothar. I think I like Cenarius making taunts and just go face for 5.
Yeah, definitely.
Because like the rag turns aren't that good right now, and the Fandral turn's clearly weaker. It's very defensive, and it probably wins you the game next turn.
Exactly. Yeah, the Dragon Warrior doesn't run any removal, only the executes.
Just the executes and
the
3 damage sources.
And the Wrath Jingle is only one.
Right.
One on the entire board. Ooh, Blackwing. Does it change anything? You can survive.
You can survive
on board, right? Yeah. You can Blackwing a 2-2.
Yeah.
Corcrom the other one.
Go face with Finley for 1.
Yes. I wield the power. And that gives you 1 extra turn, but we see Lothar having Leto, and he's really happy, as we can see. 3-0 with Jog Druid. Wow.
Yeah, it's a good deck.
It's a good deck, yeah. That's quite a conclusion here.
6-9, nice size.
6-9, yeah, really nice. Well done by Lothar. Winning 3-0 against SK Powder.
Yeah. I think, he kind of just had the draws he needed, right? Those early turns with Druid hitting the Innervates and Wild Growths at the key moments and being able to curve out is... It's extremely powerful when you get
there. Yeah, every single game, a Wild Growth or an Innervate or... He even had the coin Innervate, Wirekeeper. That's insanely strong as a Druid player.
Yeah, and Powder's draws didn't seem to line up well against Lothar's draws in the early game. Like, we saw Wirekeeper getting a value trade against Sue.
If you had the Abusive there, that would
change
a lot.
It'd be a different
lot.
Game. Yeah.
He couldn't get any value out of his Zoo minions, and most of the times it was pretty good against Druid.
Mm-hmm.
It's maybe a little bit weaker against Jog Druid, but still.
Yeah.
I still think Zoo's favorite against the Druid.
Yeah.
FPS went to 2. I couldn't grab a card.
Really?
Yeah.
You didn't play the Living Roots, right?
Yes. I wanted to play Living Roots.
Yeah.
The Nightjumper, but I couldn't just grab the card because the FPS was so low.
Yeah.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
So oh, wow.
It's really annoying how when you're drawing cards, the cards in your hand are moving around, making it very difficult.
Because they were just moving like jumping, you know?
Yeah,
oh,
they
really?
Do that.
Yeah.
It sucks.
Yeah, without animation. So I couldn't like even grab it.
What?
Yeah.
That's unfortunate. Yeah, we saw Lothar not playing the Living Roots on turn 12 or 13 or something.
Yeah.
And he's saying it like FPS issues, he couldn't grab the card.
Yeah. I mean, I know that frustration. I've played Hearthstone too.
Yeah. I think everyone watching too, yeah.
Yeah, so do you know what the next matchup is? Or?
I have literally no clue.
Yeah, me neither. But it'll be probably in a few minutes.
We see Rodu coming in. Maybe
okay.
It's him. Oh, no, he
played
yesterday.
He was in my
yesterday.
Group. Yeah. He crushed me with Zoo. Banned my Zoo, 3-0'd me with Zoo. Feels bad, man.
Feels bad, man. Yeah, Zoo seems okay.
Yeah.
If you have M Gangboss on turn 3, you win. That's how it works.
Yeah. He actually, one of the games, he skipped turn 2. He went turn 1, flame him, turn 2, tap. He just had nothing. But then, and I was like, wow, this is great, and I have a good curve and everything. but all of his other turns were just so strong. He went like turn 3 Imkang Boss, turn 4 Imkang Boss Voidwalker, and my hand just lined up against that really badly, and he managed to win, skipping turn 2.
Imkang Boss turn is 2 such is, a pain in the ass.
Yeah, and skipping turn 2 is like insane. It's such a massive disadvantage and against real curve, and he was still able to win that game because of the power of Zoo. It was amazing.
Yeah, ridiculous.
Yeah. Okay, so I think that's it for us. Stay tuned. We'll enjoy some nice meme music for a few minutes. We'll be back with some more Hearthstone.